Ocean, dripping the mic on Sunday nights, presenting you with 2020 visions. So join us this day and every Sunday night with the Mirror of the Songstress and on Blog Talk Radio, a for sure way to start your week off right. 2020 visions on Drip.
Amira the Songstress.
No regret.
You're tapped into 2020 vision. On Drip the Mic Network. All is well. Stay focused. Why with me today? It's the hip hop takeover. Uh-oh, something else trying to take over. We good? Can I see myself? There she is. First of all, I want to give a shout out. I want to shout out Dina. She beat this face, honey. Yes, she did. Yes. But like I said, I'm not alone. In the building, we have Dior. I call her the princess of hip hop.
How y'all doing?
Where's her camera? Okay.
What's up, y'all?
How y'all doing? And then we got joining us via Zoom, we got Fireman, the legendary Fireman.
Going on.
And joining us all the way from Canada, we got OG Confess. It's about to be a hip hop takeover, y'all. Y'all ain't ready. If y'all ain't ready, gonna get ready. Gonna strap on, cause it's about to be a takeover up in here. But first, I want to do my shout outs. Y'all know how I do. We got a couple of TikTok. You know what? I do want to shout out. You know, shout out my hometown, Detroit. The D. What up, though? I had a good time. Kari Aman, shout out to you. I had a wonderful shoot with you. Tobias, thank you for, just holding it down. You, your magic with the camera, brother. And then I want to thank my brother, Akbar A.B. He goes by the name of A.B. for hosting my stay. All is well in the D. Just want to shout out Detroit. But I also want to get into these TikTok videos. You know, it's this video, I want to shout out Kids Appreciation. We got this off of Instagram, but I think it was originally a TikTok video. And this little girl on this video, I mean, she's just after my own heart. Sometimes I just feel like this. Sometimes I just got to, you know, express myself in this way. And the kids do it best sometimes. Show that for me, Tony. That's how I'm feeling. How you feeling, Dior? Are you feeling like that today?
Hey, I'm feeling blessed and highly favored today.
Oh, your nails are lit. I just looked at them. Let me see.
Thank you.
Gorgeous, darling. Yes.
You see, blingy, blingy. You know, I got to do a little bling.
You got to do the bling. Y'all missing it. Y'all supposed to be here with us. Y'all missing it, Fireman. And OG, I'm telling you. That's all right. Next time.
Yes, right out. In about 12 days, I'll be in LA.
12 days?
Yeah, I should be in LA somewhere around that time.
Good. Come on home. All right. This next one is by Faith Netsy. We got this one from TikTok as well. Check this one out. I'm kind of in this mood too.
Look, I understand. If you ain't smoking weed because you got a good job, then by all means, make your paper, boo-boo. But if you ain't got no job and you not smoking weed, I don't know what the fuck you are doing with your life. I really don't. Don't give me that shit about it's a drug. It ain't no motherfucking drug. I done the research. It's just a plant. It just grow like that. And if you should happen to set it on fire, there are some effects. But that's not the same as drugs. Drugs, you got to do shit to it chemically. You got to add baking soda, water, stir it up. I don't know the recipe. I'm just saying. It's some shit you got to do to it. Well, why the fuck is it illegal? I don't know. Aspirin is perfectly legal. But if you take 13 of them motherfuckers, it'll be your last headache. Long as you've been living, you ain't never heard of a motherfucker overdose.
As long as you've been living. You ain't never heard nobody overdose on no damn marijuana. I'm just saying.
Oh.
I didn't get my daily dose today as of yet, but that's okay. That's okay. I think I can last for 2 hours.
Man.
Hint, hint, Tony. See, Tony, he he don't want the ganja in the studio. I was like, what we gonna do with Snoop Dogg get up in here? What you then you know OG gonna come.
I gotta break
OG through Snoop that. Dogg, he gonna, you know what I mean? He ain't about to come on. You gonna have to open the window or something, Tony. But that's how I'm feeling. I mean, these are just my thoughts today, you know. Want to shout out to Cherry. This one is called Killer in the House. This one is also, I found this on TikTok. Show that for me, Tony.
Hello.
I'm inside your house.
Okay. Yellow.
Why did you hang up? Why did you hang up on me?
If you're inside my house, just come talk to me.
I'm in the closet.
Oh, you're gay? That's cool.
No, I'm not gay.
No. It's all right. My cousin's gay.
No, I'm not gay. I'm literally in your closet.
Wait, really? Who is this?
Come find out.
Where are you?
Are you stupid or something? I just said I'm in your closet.
Oh, yeah.
That's what happens after you listen to Cat Williams tell you, you know, if you ain't hiding, what the fuck is going on in your life. And this last one is, I want to shout out to Dre. Dre, and I got this, I believe, TikTok as well. It's called Call Me Bro. Anyway, show this one for me, Tony.
I'm straight thugging. I'm back to the basics. Don't come to me with no brother shit, nigga. I ain't your brother. Your mama ain't had me, pussy ass nigga. I don't know your pet. One, two, three, let's go.
I particularly like that one because, like, it's like this new generation where they can just call us bro now. Like,
right. They feel like they can just do anything, it seems like, right?
Calling us bro, like.
Right. Where's Bay at?
Right.
I'm supposed to be a Bay, not your bro. That's what your bros are for.
What? OG, do you do that? You call your girl bro sometimes?
Hello. You calling her love and shit. Hey, baby.
Okay, love. Good. Good for you. What about you, Fireman? You what? What's your language like?
You know, some days, though, when women get real comfortable talking to you or something, they might be getting deep into the story. Next thing you know, they calling you girl.
So you return the favor by saying bro to
them. I don't say bro. I say baby boy, baby.
Oh,
got it. Something like that.
Oh, y'all so sweet. Look at them. Good. Good. Keep that. I do, but I do slip up every now and then and be like, girl.
I do too. I be like, girl, listen. Let me tell you about this girl and what she did. I feel like that's a girl thing, though.
Yeah, we just comfortable. Like he said, we just get real comfortable.
Shoot.
Well, without further ado, we have to get this show on the road. I'm going to read this commentary, and we're going to get into this thing. We're going to get into this takeover. I named this one Hip Hop Takeover. Where were you when you first fell in love with hip hop? Did you ever think hip hop would take it this far? The ha, the ha. straight to Africa or straight from Africa? I think the latter, like African Bambaataa. I remember traveling throughout the world hearing hip hop and understanding that hip hop has become the cornerstone of our musical language, better said, universal language. It's actually pop music, meaning popular music. Let's welcome this new age of hip hop in. Matter of fact, it's already here and it's already taken over. My guest today goes by the name of Fireman, goes by the name of Dior, and goes by the name of OG Compass. They're just some representation that I brought with me, you know, the squad, to welcome in this new era of hip hop. Y'all helped me give a warm 2020 vision. Welcome to Fireman, Dior, and OG Compass. I didn't hear you. What'd you say?
Get yourselves a hymn, goddammit.
It's going to be plenty of that. Plenty of clapping for the songstress. You know what? I'm glad you're talking because we want to start out with you, OG. We want to get to know you. And first of all, I just want you to tell the people where you're from. I know where you're from, but I want the people to know. Those that don't know you, you know.
All right, it's Pop World. I am from Toronto, yes. Canada. It is... probably the best place in the world.
Is it now?
To me.
Okay. What's going on in Toronto right now?
Quarantine. It's quarantine life, but you know, everyone's just locked up.
How you guys handle? How do you handle quarantine over there?
Yo, honestly, like they just locked everything down, so you can't go nowhere really, unless it's like an essential service or some shit, like if you want to work or something like that. But most of the time, you just have to stay home. I think it's the same thing in LA right now too.
Yeah, yeah. So you've been in the studio. What have you done to pass the time?
Yeah, I just been in the studio. Honestly, I just been turning up. Like I just been turning up little turnips and shit.
Yeah, yeah. So, with music, with hip hop, is this your dream? Is this something you've always wanted to do, or you kind of fell into it? Kind of tell us the story of how you got started.
So when it came to music for me, honestly, I kind of just fell into it. I wasn't really the music type or the rapper type. You know what I mean? It was more like something that I just did for fun with my friends. Like we'd be hustling or whatever, like whatever the case is, we'd just be hustling, doing whatever we're doing. And then it was just something we do to pass by time. Like in like, I guess like in the trap or whatever you want to say, right? Mm-hmm. And then realize I'm like, yo, like my homies were just like, yo, bro, like you're sick. Like, you know, you can really do this shit. And I'm like, you know, contemplating whether I should rap or whatever. And then I don't know, I just started going through some shit, and then going to the studio kind of just helped me get through those whatever battles I was going through at the time. And then I kind of just leaned on music after, like mm-hmm. creating music and recording kind of became like my therapy, you know. Mm-hmm. Whenever I was pissed off or I felt a certain way, I just go to the studio, make a song, and I'd leave the booth and I just feel better. And then I'd be playing it to my friends and shit, and they're like, yo bro, your music's actually good. And I'm like, fuck, all right, let's do this shit. And then, so that's the story. So it wasn't like something that I always wanted to do. It kind of just happened. It started off more as therapy, and now I'm just doing it.
So when did you decide to make a profession out of it? Like, you know, like when did, what said to you need to make some money doing this?
I don't even know. Like, let's say like 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say 3 years ago, I just made a song, and then friggin' some guy named Lior Cohen or something like flies me out to like Detroit.
Oh, Lior, huh?
Yeah, wow. So like he flew me out, and like he tried to give me like my first offer and shit, and then I was like, yo, I could do this shit for real. Like if I have like no musical, no following, and this guy found me, then fuck, I have something here, you know?
Right.
I'll just run with it. So that's what it was.
That's big. You said this guy named Lyra Coin. You know who he is, well, now,
like,
right?
That's how it was for me, because I didn't know who he was.
Yes.
He's like, yo, you know who I am? Like, seven figures, like, do your homework, kid, yeah. And all this shit.
Right.
I had no idea who he was, so I wasn't, like, stunned or awed by him, because I had no idea who he was.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it was kind of cool. But, yeah, I'd say, like, maybe a few years ago, I realized, yo, maybe I could do this rap shit for real.
Man, that sounds too easy. I mean, that sounds like the gods were smiling on you.
Yeah, that's God's timing, right? Everything, like, that's how you get it, right?
Like, people like myself, we do this thing all our lives, you know? You know, and we're trying to find it. You know, we're seeking and searching out for it, and you just kind of walked into something that you didn't know you loved, was good at it, fell in love doing it, and then, you know, out of the sky comes a Lior Cohen. That's huge. Well, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Yeah. So I have something that I want to show the people. It's called Tell Me What's Up. Can you tell me about this single before we let the people see what you're doing?
You know, as bad as it sounds, like Tell Me What's Up was like a record I made with like probably like one of like I made about like a girl. It was inspired by like probably like my first love, like my actual love. I actually like love this girl and shit, you know. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like we just didn't work out or whatever the case was. It was like probably when I was younger,
mm-hmm.
like they like when I was out in college and shit. Yes. So I don't know. I just made a song about that relationship, really. So that's all it was. It was really about just an ex, I guess, a couple exes, and I just pulled situations from all over the place,
mm-hmm.
and I put it together, and then yeah, Tell Me What's Up just came about.
See, that's good enough. We like love, you know. We like songs about us.
Love is always a perfect topic. You can never go wrong.
Right. Okay. All right. Without further ado, let's take a look at Tell Me What's Up.
All right. Let's do it.
Tell me what's up. Tell me what's up. Tell me what's up. Scrapping up.
I was the first to remember me catching bare bodies assembly. Giving it up, be upsetting me. Give a good dick, be the remedy. Pull up and sip on some Hennessy. Hit up the club, sip on bubbly. Baby, don't fight it, don't front on me. Having one sex, be so heavenly. Stack up and flipping, no poverty. Stack up and sit on some property. I just keep goals like a soccer team. Stand up, she like it so properly. She keep me good brain like she Socrates. Baby, don't fight it, don't front on me. Baby, don't fight it, don't front on me. Baby, I'm gonna make you remember me. Buy you whatever you wish, I'm in love with you. Break up to make up, so lovers do. Stay up to kick up, so hustlers do. Heart is so cold, I still loving you. Bonnie and Clyde, I fuck with you. Break up to make up, so lovers do. Do me this favor.
Do me this favor.
And tell me what's up with you.
Need me like, yeah, she be calling. She know that, yeah, we be balling.
I love it. Dope, dope, and more dope.
Thank you, thank you.
That was a feel-good song.
Yeah. It's a vibe.
I probably would tell you what's up if, you know, if you were saying it that many times. I probably would tell you that what's up. So tell me about your name, OG Compass. Where'd you get the name from?
All right, so, like, my name just always, like, well, like, Compass was something I just, like, I don't know, I was just, like, I kind of gave myself that name,
mm-hmm.
but like my nickname was BG. Like when I was a kid, my name was YG.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I got older, like let's say like my early 20s and shit,
mm-hmm.
I came to BG and now I'm fucking whatever. I'm like 28 now. So now it's just OG.
Oh,
it just goes by the age.
Okay.
Age, it just keeps changing.
Is it going to change again?
Probably not. I probably like G Compass, but like I just put the O on it just because, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, no, yeah. I think it's dope. Definitely catchy. You know, I was go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was just like I guess I was like that friend that like anytime someone needs help and whatever, like I'm always like just leading people in the right direction and shit. So I kind of just gave myself that name, you know, Compass.
That's beautiful.
That's how I came up with it.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
I'm sure that, you know, permeates through your music too, you know, just that relatable person, someone that's kind of been there for, you know, that's been there for you and actually been through some of the things that you've actually been through. So as long as that keeps coming through the music, I believe that's how you win.
Thank you. Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah. Yeah. So I have all three of you here. So is there any connection between the three of you guys? You know, we got Fireman, the legendary Fireman, the Grammy nominated producer and artist. Then we got, you know, we got OG Compass in Canada. Then we got our little princess here in LA, Dior. So what is there a connection between the three of you guys that, you know, that you guys want to talk about?
What do you mean by connection?
Like, you guys work with some of the same people. Have you guys collabed on anything?
I think our background and all be the same when it comes to, like, I met Fireman in LA, like, what, like, a couple times? Like, 3 years ago, maybe? 2 years ago? And I think I met him through, like, Malik Youssef.
Okay, I know Malik as well. That's, like, my OG. Yeah. My OG.
Yeah, so, we're working on music, right? So I flew out there to, like, work on, like, songs and shit, and then signed my Fireman, really. So, yeah, I think Malik would be, like,
the connection.
It's definitely Malik. Shout out to Malik Youssef.
Hey, shout out to Malik Youssef.
Shout out to the OG. You said it well.
He's in Africa right now, in Nigeria.
He's lit.
Yeah. He's out there being a judge for their African idol. So shout out to you all the way in Africa, brother.
Shout out.
That's my brother. That's my mentor.
Yeah.
Real close guy. We real close together, type stuff. And that's how I met, you know, that's how I met, bro. Yeah.
And then, so have you and Fireman worked together, Dior?
I've never worked with Fireman or met Fireman, but hi, Fireman. I hope we work together soon.
Yeah. Yeah, Fireman and I got a fire track together, and it's coming out 1/1/21. And Malik Youssef is also the producer on the track. Hey. So, yeah, we family, we squad around here.
Hello, not one of
them. Huh?
It's one of those, not one of them.
Yeah. Hey, Fire, did you say you met him OG 20 years ago? Is that what you said?
No, I met Malik probably about like maybe about almost like 6 years ago, maybe 6 years ago or something like that. Like, we've been rocking for a long time.
Okay. Yeah. I remember it. Cause I met you in like what, 2017, right after the Grammys, that Grammy win with Beyonce.
Yep. Was that for Sandcastles?
Yep. Been rocking ever since. So we can move this train down the road. You know, I wanted to celebrate you guys and let everybody know that, you know, don't be afraid of this new era of hip hop that's, you know, coming in. Like, don't be afraid of it. Some people get mad because, you know, we don't do the things the way it was done, you know, back in the day. But that don't mean it's not just as good. You know, we tend to sensationalize everything that's older, and not to disrespect anything that came before us. But everything has to elevate. Everything has to evolve. And, you know, it's just like running a race, you know, with a baton. You have to pass the baton, and whatever that person that has the baton is going to do with it next, then it's up to them to do what they to take it as far as they can take it. And I just wanted to kind of take a moment to celebrate you guys and, you know, just say congratulations for taking it as far as you guys have been able to take it. So we have a little video we like to show to our guests and just celebrate some of the artists that we love as well as you all. Can you play that for me?
All eyes on me, live the life of a thug nigga, until the day I die, live the life of a boss player. All eyes on me, afford that, like a car that I can't afford. I would want it, then want some more. The persistence our frames explore, let me know she was secure. Back for more, I wanna go, 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 go. And on the count of three, go, go. Are you sure that you wanna?
I seen it in the dreams and I put off the lot with it. Be up for the lot in this. Seeing is believing, if you love me then just ride with me. Just fly with me. You better pay attention, girl, and spread your wings and get high with me. She right by the motel, or maybe in the hotel. She up late nights just going through her own hell. She dancing like she old though. Make money in a cold world. We all through our own hell.
Are you sure that you wanna? Say.
shit, whole lot of gang shit, gang shit, whole lot of gang, 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 whole lot of gang shit. You want some lame shit? We twisting fingers up, sign language. Ain't wanna bring it up, but you been a bitch. I can't beef with broke niggas, what's the benefit? Shake it like a trump, and she selling stamps. I like hood bitches that never gave a damn. She be flu-flamming niggas. The way I see it, it's only two kind of niggas. Niggas that make shit happen, niggas that let shit happen to them. Keep on yapping, we gon' put a clap into them. I stay with clips like for real, don't ask what happened to them. Get in your lane, don't swerve in mine. Cause right now it's a whole lot of gang shit, gang shit.
Yes, congratulations, you all. We wanted to just show our appreciation to you guys and thank you for bringing in this new era of hip hop and bringing that drip to the table. we usually do a toast right about now, and each month we feature a new bottle of whiskey, and Mr. Cook tells us all about it, and then we're going to propose a toast to you guys.
All right, so this month we decided to go with a Woodford Reserve. It is another Kentucky Spice bourbon, small batch bourbon. Went with this one due to a suggestion from AB. So shout out to AB for suggesting it. He really
Detroit,
liked it, so we decided
AB,
we'll do it this
up,
month.
Though?
And it's very similar to some of the other some of the other bourbons or the rye whiskey that you had before. So it's got a little bit stronger of a taste to it.
Peppery.
Than that, yeah, but this one's a little bit smoother than the last two that I think that you had.
All right, okay. So if you out there in YouTube land. If you're watching and listening out there in Facebook land, where you're watching and listening, and Twitter, I know y'all watching and listening, and IG Live, y'all like to watch behind the scenes. What up, though? What up, though? Y'all raise y'all glasses with us. We want to toast to the new era of hip hop. We want to toast to Fireman, Dior, and OG Compass. We want to thank y'all for bringing it to us. Salud to you. Did you down yours? Girl, you crazy. Look. Put the camera on Dior.
Take it to the head.
Put the camera on Dior. Look at her. You weren't supposed to sip. Pour her some more.
Take it to the head.
You're supposed to sip this. I don't even know how to pour it. I don't even know why I'm grabbing. We're going to have to give her some more. She's
that's that whiskey. That's that. That's that strong, strong.
She like Janae number two. You gonna water? She ain't need no water.
Oh yeah, I took that water right after too. You saw me grab that. Oh, he's got the blunt. Look.
See, I'm so envious of you, Fireman. Like you got it all over there. How y'all feeling?
Good.
Yeah. This is a good one. Peppery one. It's a good one.
It's real smoky.
We gonna just kick it and have this conversation. Mind y'all, if y'all want to chime in and ask any questions to each other, you know, y'all want to chime in on the story, that's fine. It's all family here. So I'm gonna ask Dior a few questions, but you know, it's open if anybody else want to chime in with her for her. But Dior, so now I'm calling you Cali's own princess of hip hop.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. But where are you? Are you originally from Cali?
I'm originally from Cali. I've literally lived like all throughout LA. My dad is from Inglewood, born and raised.
Inglewood?
So, yeah, she's from Inglewood. But with my mom growing up, I just moved a lot all through LA. You know, her job was always relocating us. So, I literally just kind of grew up in like almost every city.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy. So, thank you so much for that, though. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I know we've been taking care of you, you know. You're making your way through, you know, through your career.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
Seems like you've landed with the right people.
I definitely have. I'm very blessed.
Yes.
Man, I can't even describe it.
Yeah. I mean, shoot, you got Malik Yousef on your team.
I know.
Burundi on your team.
Man.
So, you know. Let's see. There was something else I wanted to ask you. So how has the support of Cali, how has it helped you in your career? When you know, you have the support of your hometown. I know your parents has been in your corner. Obviously, like I said, you've landed with the right people. How has that, you know, helped you? How has that manifested in your career?
It's definitely helped me, you know, just getting support. Like, I've always, like, been into, you know, being social and being out. I mean, since I was young, like, my mom always told me, like, just go out and, like, make a name for yourself, you know, just, like, get to know people. Yes. So, you know, when I started doing music, I just started getting a lot of respect, you know, off the bat. So I'm really thankful for that, you know, that I just automatically got that. Because I know it's really hard for female artists to get respect.
Yeah.
Just because we're looked at as, like, we have to be super sexual or whatever the case is. But luckily, like, me just being me and knowing people, I just got support. And I don't know. I guess I'm one of the lucky ones.
It's a blessing. Definitely.
It is. Definitely.
Yeah. Yep. So we have a video from you called Unavailable. Okay.
Unavailable.
I want to hear that. Can you set up the video, set up the song for us. Tell us what it's about.
So basically this song is about somebody I was dating at the time, who I love very much. She had a very crazy life, you know, and I don't know. I was just really confused with where my heart was. Yes. Not necessarily where he was concerned, but just being unavailable, like, you know, as far as love. Yes. Like, I was accepting love, but I just was so scared to, you know, really get deep into it because I knew, like, the type of life that he had at the moment. Yeah. And just, you know, the song really speaks for itself. Like, all my feelings are true feelings in that song, you know. Everything, you know, from the start to the beginning of the song. And a video, actually, the day that I was going to shoot the video, I feel like I got tested by God because a trunk fell on my forehead.
What?
Yeah, you can kind of see it in the video, but I had a concussion.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
And you shot anyway, though.
I shot it anyway. Even now, my eyes are swollen, and I'm like, I still got to come because I got my lashes done.
Yeah.
Like, I ain't got no excuse. So I'm about to show up. You know what I'm saying?
That's a real artist, like, for real.
Yeah. So, you know, literally, it was like when I was putting my stuff in the trunk, you know, I was getting my stuff ready, and I had my mom there. Shout out to my mom. I know you're watching this. Aww. I love you.
What's your mom's name?
Trinity.
Trinity, shout out to you, Trinity. You
shout out
raised
to you.
A beautiful young lady, very talented young lady.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, and I love that advice you gave her, Trinity. Go out there and make a name for yourself.
Yes, be yourself. She never stopped me from being myself, so I'm really thankful for that. But yeah, so the trunk literally fell on my head. I'm like, oh, okay, we're ready. I'm going to the location. Fell. I'm like, oh my God, everybody's calling me. You need to go to the ER. You need to go to the ER. I'm like, no, I got to go. So I just kept switching ice packs the whole way up to location. Yeah. Now the video is in Pasadena where I live the most.
Okay.
You know, out of moving so many different places throughout the years. And there was a hiking trail in Pasadena that I used to go to, and I used to actually write and sing and, you know, go up to, like, there was like a secret little trail where I could go up. And I found it, and I'm like, okay, this is my spot. You know, no one's gonna know about this. And I would just go up there and, you know, sing. And at the time, you know, you have to have a lot of confidence to do music, and I just wasn't ready for that yet. But I always loved it. And I just went back to the place where I really found myself, and that's where I filmed it at. We filmed it, and the day was so beautiful when I got the concussion. I'm like, nah, God's testing me. I know he is. I know he's testing me to see if I really want
this. Want this, yeah.
Yeah, and so I did it anyway.
You know, you and know? All is well.
Yeah.
And congratulations. Without further ado, Unavailable.
Hey.
How I'm get the dashing and idea, they can't flow with me. I can't put up with your shit, you too low to me. Please don't hear me when I'm lit, you know it's slow with me. You've been chasing girls, but they ain't like me. You could feel that void, but they ain't wifey. And if you feel the way, then you could write me. But I can't catch no feelings, cause you're trifling. And you know I be shining like a bright lamp. And watch me ride a stick without no license. He say my body looking so enticing. He going round for round just like he Tyson. I'm unavailable, can't fuck with me. I'm unavailable, can't love on me. I'm unavailable, can't love on me. Don't love on me, don't love on me. I'm unavailable, can't fuck with me. I'm unavailable, can't love on me. I'm unavailable, don't love on me. Don't love me, don't love me.
Love it.
Thank you so much.
It's sexy, it's sensual, it's everything. And I know
Thank you.
I know it's emotional, but it just it felt very sensual. I know he mad.
He definitely felt that one after the video. Like, you know, really the song is just about, like, you know, being unavailable. Like, don't love me. That's exactly what I said. Because, like, you know, if you can't love me fully, then don't love me at all, you know. But I was really in love with somebody, you know, at the time. I was feeling a little heartbroken, I'm not gonna lie. I was like, damn, I'm unavailable. Why you gotta do me like this and mess with these hoes?
Who was laughing? OG, was that you cracking up? Talking about don't.
That was funny.
Huh?
He said that was funny.
So if somebody told you don't love me, you just would laugh? Like.
Yeah, like, that's cold. She's cold.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm cold, like ice. Nah.
Sometimes we be praying to be like, we're like, please just let me stop caring, dear God.
Yeah.
Please just give me a ice cold heart so I don't have to care no more.
let me be unavailable for love at this point.
Yes.
No, it's like, damn.
Love will always find you though.
Yeah, of course. You know.
Yeah. No. I like it. I love it.
Thank you so much.
Yep. And then. You have, you know, you mentioned Malik Yousef earlier, and you have a special project that you were involved with, that this particular song was involved with.
Yes.
What's the name of that song?
The song is called Minutes.
Okay, okay. And tell me about how you actually got on that project with Malik Yousef with this particular song.
Well, I had met Malik through he was like my manager at the time. Well, he wanted to manage me, and me and him both knew some of the same people.
Yeah.
And then he had told me about Malik, and I was like, wow, that's so dope. Yeah, like, you know. And so I had met Malik. Actually, we went to get dinner, and I actually brought my mom's because I was like, I want him to see, like, you know what my family side and see what it is.
Right. Yeah.
And we ended up eating at the Cheesecake Factory, you know, and we just talked. Like, I feel like we literally crunched like our whole lives into one dinner. Like, he told me so much stuff and just put me on game, and I was just like, wow. And, you know, at first he was just going to help me, like, you know, with my project and stuff. But then we just kind of built a really good relationship.
Yeah.
And, well, at first I landed on a playlist. And I had to remix an old Death Row song. And I had a song called Woman to Woman.
Oh, okay.
But that fell through.
Okay.
So then he had told me that he had another opportunity for a mixtape that he was putting together. Mm-hmm. And it's called Battleship Earth. And I was like, oh, that's hard. Yeah. And then I made a song that was kind of like, it kind of went with the whole Battleship Earth thing, like spacey, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't seen you in a minute. So I was like, oh. So I sent it in. He's like, all right.
That's it.
That's it right there.
Well, you know, we have a little snippet from it that we want to play just so the people can hear what it is. And then where is this particular mixtape? It's out now?
Yes, this mixtape is out now, and I actually had a song on Apple Music.
Okay.
As well, Apple Music, Spotify.
Okay.
Yeah, SoundCloud. All right.
So we're going to let the people get a little taste of it, and then they can go buy it, stream it.
Stream that motherfucker.
Okay. All right. Let's hear a minute for it. Let's hear a quick minute of the minute.
Quick minute. You think you lit. You think you lit. So you legit. So you legit. I'm really bad if we could get to it. Watch how I move, watch how I move, watch how I move. You say you that dude, you say you that dude, you say you that dude. I know you went and got the word on me. Can you pull up, just swerve on me? Cause I ain't seen you in a minute. I ain't seen you in a minute. I ain't seen you in a minute. What you want? Where you at? Cause I ain't seen you in a minute.
Yeah. Just a little taste of it.
Just a little taste.
If they whistles wet. Y'all go get that. Y'all go stream it. It's on Apple Music. You can also find the mixtape everywhere, like Spotify, Tidal, iTunes.
Hey.
You know, it's called, what is it called, the mixtape?
It's called Minute. Oh, but the mixtape is called Battleship Earth. That's actually on DatPiff, which if you go to Malik's bio,
yeah,
I'm pretty sure he has it on his website right there, too.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Go cop that. I love it. I love everything that I've heard. So I know, you know, we're saying hip hop artists, but you got vocals. Yes.
Thank you so much.
So, you know, you're just an artist. Let's just say that.
Yeah, I like to, you know, sway between genres sometimes. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't really like to box myself because every time I go in the studio, I really just find like something new that I never knew existed.
Yes.
So, yeah, that's really. I don't know. I just surprise myself every time.
So growing up, was it the desire more towards hip hop or actually, you know, rapping or actually singing, or just kind of they just grew together for you? Which one?
I definitely feel like they grew together for me. Mm-hmm. You know, I tried out for America's Got Talent with my mom when I was so young.
Yeah.
My mom used to actually sing.
Uh-huh.
And she would get on me about singing and stuff because she's like, don't lose your voice by smoking backwards. And stuff. So I'm like, dang, yeah, I know you listening to this
fuck
too.
Those papers, baby. It's a whole different. Go ahead. That's a whole different show. I'm sorry. Go ahead. I'm
that's
listening.
A whole different show. So I always love music.
Uh-huh.
I just, like I was telling you earlier, you know, I know that music, you have to have a lot of confidence. And you know, I understood that at the time, you know, I went through a lot when I was younger, and I really didn't have the confidence. I just was always dealing with something, and I couldn't really sit down and really, you know, be, you know, strategic about what I really wanted. And I mean, I would feel like when I first started really, you know, trying to do music, it was more so singing.
Mm-hmm.
But I always loved to rap too. You know, I was just like, I gotta find like my cadence in rapping because I don't want to sound like nobody else. And it's not that I thought I sounded like somebody else. It's just that I just wanted to make sure that I knew what my sound was, so I can kind of just like stamp that.
That's smart.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You did that.
Thank you.
You stamped that.
Thank you so much.
I love it. All right. Well, we got some chatters, huh? We got some chatters and Is anybody calling on the line? We do got some chatters. We just want to see what they're talking about, and we'll move this train down the road. Y'all got any of the panel? Y'all got questions for Dior? Y'all can talk. Y'all can feel free.
My question is, where do you see yourself in terms of in the next 2 years when it comes to where you want to be as an artist?
Where do I see myself? I see myself very successful. I would say one, you know, I mean, we all hope to be successful in anything that we're pursuing. But I would just hope to see myself established and, you know, to have some respect on my name. You know what I'm saying? I definitely look forward to that. It's not really, it's not about the money to me. It's about a dream. I've been offered multiple, you know, deals and stuff like that, or, you know, management wanted to manage me. And I've turned those down because I want to have creative freedom, you know, and I want to be myself. I don't want to be over-sexualized. I'm not, you know, that type of artist. And I just, like I said, I want to be established, you know, where the industry is concerned, and, you know, be successful. And I believe in myself that I can do that. So.
That's dope.
As long as you work hard, just work hard, you'll get there.
Exactly. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that.
Red Hot or Louisiana?
Red Hot or Louisiana? Dang. I would say Louisiana.
Yes. No, Red Hot for me.
Red Hot. I ain't gonna lie to you though, I ain't really into hot sauce like that. But we know when you pop out the hot sauce, it has to be the Louisiana. Yeah.
You know, that's funny. Because I don't like hot stuff either.
Right.
But I grew up on Red Hot.
Okay.
And so for me, it's the taste. It gives stuff the seasoning. Like, you gotta have it on chicken. You gotta have it on fish. Like, it's the seasoning of it. But it's probably just as hot as Louisiana. But I wouldn't know because I was, you know.
Right.
But hot stuff as a rule, I can't, because it doesn't make sense to me. Yeah. It's like, if I can't taste the food because it's burning my mouth, why are we
doing
this?
What's the point?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not gonna lie. Like, hot sauce, I really always, like, when I'm sick. Oh, I pour that into the soup. Hot sauce helps when you're sick, you know.
Yep.
But I'm not really like somebody that just go to some hot sauce. But I know hot sauce is a very special condiment for a lot of people. So
swag.
No shade to the hot sauce.
All right, we have some comments from Facebook and YouTube. Facebook, AB said, hey, sup, what's up, though? Make sure y'all kill that bottle. He's laughing his ass off at that time. He's the one that recommended the bottle for us. And he said about Dior, she's cute.
Thank you so much.
And he said it's definitely one of our babies. You know, he's aging us. He's letting you know that, you know, there's kids in the family your age. So it's like. From YouTube, we have Pretty Missy. Shout out to Dior.
Thank you so much.
I love the path you are on. Keep doing beautiful things, baby girl.
Thank you so much. I'm pretty sure I know who this is. Thank you, Aisha. I love you.
And then YouTube also, Beauty and Flaws. It says, hey, friend, looking beautiful as usual. This is Renisha.
Thank you so much. Yeah, Thank you.
They own you.
They own me. I appreciate y'all for real.
All right. So we're going to move on down the road. We have none other than Fireman Man, the Grammy nominated producer as well as artist. And I want to welcome you to the show. We gonna talk to you, honey. We gonna get some information from you. You gotta teach and preach for us today. I can't. Did it mute him? Is he frozen?
Yeah, it's frozen.
Uh oh. Is it? And it's been cool the whole time.
That's crazy.
He's frozen in that spot with his mouth open. Hey. Yeah, so until we can, like, is it our end or his end?
Is the audio working?
Who said that?
Audio work?
Yeah, okay. We can hear you.
I don't know if it's the audio or the video. My bad. I don't know what's going on.
It's all good. All right. Put him on the big screen. Okay. All right. I have a few questions to kick off this conversation with you. You know, okay. We got a star amongst us. Now, how do you manage the dynamics of being a producer versus artist? how do you, I don't know, how do you reconcile that in your mind? Like, you're producing for all these phenomenal artists, but you also have to give yourself some of that, you know, love and creativity. So how do you manage that?
I think I just all let it out, let all my purpose try to melt together as one. I try not to be scattered.
Okay. Do you find yourself, did it froze again? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you find yourself, just once you're in that creative space, it doesn't matter. You can be creating something and it could feel good for you, or it could just feel good for someone else. You just find yourself kind of just sitting in that creative space and not judging it.
I think I just use it as I just cut it on when it's time to cut it on, depending on what it's for.
Okay.
So if I'm in, I usually just kind of create art with my friends and with people that I'm around, you know what I'm saying? So it's more like when me and you in the studio, I'll try to aid and assist my people. So if they doing some songs, then I'm going to come with the melodies and come with the, you feel me, ideas and stuff like that to the beats. Most of the time when I'm doing my own artistry, I'm going to do that regardless.
Right.
And it all just mixed together. Like, I'm doing a song, I'm working with Malik on some music, producing his music, but at the same time, that bleed into me doing a project with him too, as an artist, both together. Same with, I like to collaborate with different artists that I work with.
Yeah. Did it freeze again? Or did he stop talking? Thank you, Frosky. What you say, Fire? We got you now.
Yeah, we just keep it natural.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
We just keep it natural. Have fun with it.
I can understand it. So you have a new project out that, it's only been out, a couple of weeks now, a few weeks?
Yeah, it's called Purple Heart.
Yes. Can you talk to me a little bit about the Purple Heart? Well, first of all, why did you name the project Purple Heart?
Well, the project is called Purple Heart. First of all, it's hosted by Malik Youssef, DJ Good Music. It's hosted by my big dog, you feel me? So it's a project, and it's about Chicago and in relation to everywhere else as well, you feel me? But just being from the situations that we come from, the environments that we come from, and, you know, just the stronghold that they have on us, and just all the things that you just go through when when you're coming up in impoverished communities, that's in the hood, all that type of stuff, the oppressed people, a lot of times, the stories of that, and the feelings of that, the fun, the down parts, the sad, the bad,
Hello. Wow. Okay.
And you do something going on, and then when you as much as we go through here at home, the fact that the country and the government has seemed to be at war with us the whole time, I feel like we deserve a Purple Heart down there. How much we've been through, type shit.
Come on. Yeah.
So I just come with that, and I put my friends and relatives on the on the cover as well, in their memories of them.
That's beautiful.
Yeah. So yeah, I just rock it out and just sound like you're in Chicago, the whole project, it's your turn.
That's beautiful.
And it's real.
That's beautiful. I want to get into one of the songs. I actually want to show one of the videos called Dear Mr. President. And when we come back, we're going to get more into your project and, unravel this thing and talk to the people about it. Also, as well as your career.
Okay, cool.
But without further ado, Dear Mr. President.
Yeah.
Ho! A legendary fireman.
Man. Oh God. Oh God.
If clout is a drug, these niggas is addicts. They'll do anything for it like it was they family. I'm rapping with a gat, don't you think that it's candy? I hold it on stage like it was a Grammy. Not to be confused with these YouTube views. Seeking niggas put the work on the scale. It said to be continued. Niggas barely buy their baby summer clothes. It get hot outside, they worry about some summer hoes. It's billions of dollars, I need some of those. At least one of those, at least one of those. I know my ex talk about me badly, but damn, you the eighth motherfucker to tag me. I got a couple bigger fishes to fry. They want a noose around my neck like it was a tie. That's what happened when you represent Chicago this much. It's time to get even, cause the odds against us. The ops is clicked up with cops that frisk us. Middle finger up like, ah, you missed us. It's that real shit, trill shit, block shit. It's that hot shit, put it on your watch list. It's that real shit, trill shit, block shit. It's that hot shit, put it on your watch list. I can't wait to see it when you ride on me. Snatch the soul that's inside of me. Make it slide on me. And the devil keep her eyes on me. I think I accidentally took her on a shopping spree. I'm voting for me. Ben Frank is my president. Yeah. 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 I know some P Rangers, the niggas power thugging. Only time my phone don't ring is when I click that power button. Our budget is nothing the same. You saving to buy some plane tickets? I'm thinking about copping the plane. Shots at his brain. Used to get juice at the rink, acting ratchet, but now it's ratchets under the sink. I'm Chicago as hell, like MacArthur's and Harold. Since a little cub, I was hitting bears with the barrel. It's terrible how my parables tear through you. I'm from the city where the mirrors shoot you. Then hide the footage. I use your skin to hide bullets. I pull it on the bus like my stop next. I'm a monster pop locking with the Loch Ness. Don't you ever play yourself like solitary, cause niggas will tail on you and leave you in solitary. Bunch of pussy niggas fighting with rats. Tom and Jerry, itchy and scratchy. I mean you niggas face like acne. Rappers is whack. I pray to God they get whack, and they better get God on they track, cause I'm bodying that. Nigga, I'm from where the homies is at. Take a walk with me to Holston where the zombies is at. Can't find the heart of anything to cut the knife into. Don't make Nina have to cut your damn life into. She gon' make your ass dash like a hyphen do. And the struggle is real when you hustle to live. And you fuss with them pills, tryna fucking just feel. You need something that's real, so you fucking with fire. Word advice, all these rap niggas fucking liars. Ben Frank is my president. Yeah. Ben Frank is my president. Is my president, yeah. Ben Frank is my president, yeah. Pretty brown bitch, and her hair short like she Amber. Do it for the camera, do it for the camera. The way she give me knowledge, I didn't know she know the answer. House so big, I think I'ma need some cameras. It's that real shit, trill shit, block shit. It's that hot shit, put it on your watch list. It's that real shit, trill shit, block shit. It's that hot shit, put it on your watch list.
Us. It's the real shit, chill shit. Put it on your wife's list. That's my favorite one so far.
Yeah, that shit hard.
It goes. It goes. I love the way, you know, obviously you're teaching, you're spitting knowledge, you know, education is key. You know, I love the way you do that, but you make it fun, you know.
Yeah, I'm talking some shit one time too at the same time.
Yeah, and you know, you show love, you know, you get us, you know, but you still get us hyped. I love it. You're, you know, definitely a true artist. I love your art. We was over here talking about, Dior was over here saying how you are a lyricist.
Yes. Oh my goodness. Crazy. Lyrics is crazy. Definitely want to work with you one day. I think he froze.
Oh, he's saying something too. I'm sure he's saying, it's probably good. Dang. What he's saying.
Oh, he's back.
He's back. What you say,
Hey, peace.
You are amazing lyricist too, and we're gonna definitely work on some shit.
Appreciate you, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I see you look like your mind is turning, like you want to add on to it.
Oh no. I'll just no, nothing.
Okay. Y'all, like, it, they almost remind me just a little bit of each other, like, you know, OG and Fireman, oh, just a too. Little bit, like, when I was going through their, you know, their music and their, like, just their demeanor, their style a little bit, you know. Right, yeah. But, you know, OG, you would be the baby, though. You would be like the, you know what I mean? The, you know? And then. But, yeah. So, obviously, I mean, this is kind of a redundant question. What is the inspiration behind Dear Mr. President? And it's very obvious. But I just, I kind of want to know where your headspace, you know, where you were when you were, you know, writing the that particular song, like, you know, yeah, just let's talk about that.
Other artists, well, my artists that I work with. So uh-huh. For me, what I do is I just, you know, I'm painting a picture by cutting the mic on. And usually, especially like Malik, I definitely got that from him, especially when I work in big studios. Uh-huh. I like to be really intimate, take the mic, put it in the middle of the room instead of in a booth or something.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. And then I just listen to the beat and this particular beat, I made this beat and produced this beat too, uh-huh. You know. So I just really just saw the picture in my head or the picture I was trying to paint, uh-huh. But not beforehand though.
Yeah.
I kind of just put the mic on. And I started just, you know, just letting out what's in my soul type shit.
Right.
And, you know, that's kind of what the record led me to say. Like, every beat to me just tell me to say something to it. I just listen and say what it's saying.
What
to
the
me
music is saying. Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah, I just listen. And I just let it out. Just say the lines, say the feelings that I'm saying, what I've been through, what I've seen, all that. And, yeah.
Yeah.
Tell a story of my city.
Right, right. I love it. Yeah, I was the last time you and I were in the studio. That's how it went, huh? We were at Universal Records and Universal Studios, and we were, Malik just put the mic in the middle, and we just all started taking turns. Like you pulled up the track because I think there was some other producers in there, but you were like, yeah, he talked. He was like, you know, anybody got something, pull it up. You know, you was like, well, he talking to me. So you was like, I got some.
Hey, we had to get, catch a body real quick.
You know, and you pulled up the track, and that was that. It became everything, you know, literally. So yeah, I think that's a great process.
Man, it was fun too. That's the thing. Like, it's fun, just naturally having fun with it. You know, we ain't putting stress on it. We just enjoying it. You feel me?
Yeah.
It's soul music, you feel me? That's so right. It ain't really, it's soul music. We just letting our soul. Just let us.
So I promised the people that you would talk a little bit about, you know, the strategies of the way you win in the industry. And I keep letting everyone know that you're Grammy nominated producer as well as artist. And I just want, you know, just give us a few jewels, you know, here on 2020 Vision, you know, we love art, you know, we love creativity. But, yeah. You know, I would be remiss not to tell you that we use it as a vessel to take people to their higher level so we can get, you know, so we can get high. We always trying to get high on 2020 Vision. So, you know, I always ask the people, you know, just give them a few jewels that they can take with you. It's a lot of artists that watch this show. It's a lot of people striving and wanting to know the answers. You know, how do you break through? What is that magic? What is that secret? And while we know there's not just one secret or there's not just one piece of magic that we use, it's a conglomerate of things. Just if you can lend, you know, just a little bit of your expertise, you know, to the people. And let's talk about your strategic wins and, you know, how they formulate it for you or how you formulated them for yourself, I should say.
Well, it's funny that you spoke about getting high. You know, I was... just in the position of trying to get high, so to speak, and I knew that. So my strategy, being the fact that I'm a producer and an artist and a film director, I just knew, like, okay, I can utilize my other true passion, which is just helping stars be stars or just trying to help people be what they want to be. being great at that.
Okay.
So I just like studied like a lot of the super producers.
I know he's trying to drop some jewels too.
Producers were developing artists instead of just making beats.
Okay.
So for me, I felt like it was important to like Timbaland with Aaliyah and all those type of people.
Yes.
So I like just my frequency that I had going on and the things that I was just trying to just manifest with myself, they kind of always put me around certain people that I just believed in, and those people grew into being, it just like put me around them right at the right time, like right before they even be that.
Mm-hmm.
But they showing signs that like they for real at it, and they got talent. So then I just help them and produce their records, get them ideas with their stuff. And then, you know, that's kind of what put me in certain positions and got me a lot of notoriety, like by helping create the drill movement and being a part of that whole scene. You know, with Lil Durk when he was a young teenager before he really, this was his breakthrough moment, these moments like this. And we, you know, behind him, a lot of people, and well, not a lot of people, but other people as well. But, you know, that kind of, it was like moments like that. That's just one certain moment. So the one.
Just a few technical difficulties, you guys. He'll be back. There he is. Okay. What was the last thing you said, Fireman? We lost you.
Usually the wins is usually a not just one moment that happened. It's really no magic, no hocus pocus to it.
Hmm.
It's just usually a series of events.
That's right.
Those events were usually chained off by helping people.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Grammy nomination, that yeah. started off as me helping somebody. Like I was my guy Malik, actually, he called me. He was like, man, will you go up to Oakland? I'm busy right now. I can't do what I'm doing this and I need to do that. Can you go up to Oakland and do that for me?
Hmm.
So I'm like, all right, cool. He wanted me to pick up a whole class for him. So it was me and G Seal and some people with me. I think like Tanner or somebody. And we went all the way up there for him. And it wasn't even a thought, you know what I'm saying? Because that's my dog. You know, he done a lot for me. And any chance I get, if he asks me for something, I'm going to, you feel me, facilitate
right.
that for him too. So just helping, being of age.
Okay. He'll be back. I got faith.
Is I'm back?
Yeah, you're back now. Back. You said, I think you were saying being obedient. Go ahead.
Just being an aid and a sister of people okay. around you.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say necessarily obedience, but just helping people. You know, even if it's your stranger or it's your people, that usually leads you to some dope shit.
Yeah.
So it's like, and it says big bro, then that put me around the Alphabet Rockers at that time again, some people that I'm cool with up there in Oakland, because I was up there.
Uh-huh.
For doing that, I worked on their album with them while I was up there.
Yeah.
Got nominated for a Grammy.
Wow.
I didn't put a cheat code in, nothing. I just, the cheat code, simple, just put your mind on some dope shit, do dope shit, help people do dope shit, help people in general. It's going to come to you, just meet the and helping the right people. You can't just help everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Then you're just going to be goofy, on goofy time. On goofy time, instantly. So you just help the wrong people.
Yeah.
So if you try to use good discern on which to who to help out and who to, you know, put your energy into.
Uh-huh.
And what to put your energy into, and it's gonna fall.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like you know, definitely that saying, you know, the servant is the master, you know, that's very applicable, you know, around this whole team, around this whole family of people, you know, all of the inner, you know, the thing that continues to connect us, Malik Yusuf, but you know, this whole family, this whole squad, you know, just, I think that phrase permeates through, you know, us and how we move about in the industry.
Definitely.
The servant is the master. And when you, do good things for good people, it has no choice but to come back to you. You know, obviously you put in the universe what you want to get out of it. You know, you have mm-hmm. to deposit money in the bank in order for it, you know, in order to take money out of it. So however much you put in is typically, well, you know what? I wouldn't even say it's how much you get back, because sometimes you put in a little bit and you get double, you know, or triple that thing back, you know, because it meant that much, you know, to the universe. It meant that much to what you gave actually grew and replenished the universe and helped it evolve in some kind of way. And, you know, thus Grammys and, you know, million, you know, platinum records are are sometimes a result or manifestation of that. So, yeah, you know, congratulations yeah. you for understanding that. It looks like he froze again. When you, I know your you can, role. Huh?
I just think it's important to just play your role.
Yeah.
And just do your shit. Like, yeah. Play your role and go hard. Like, don't be what you say you're going to be. Do what you say you're going to do when you say you were going to do it. That's most of the whole industry shit. Too.
Come on.
Like,
right. Yeah.
Be a person that motherfuckers don't want to rock with. Excuse my language. You're going to be a person. You got to be a person that people want to be around.
They can rely on. Right.
Or even better, that they need you. Not need you, but could use you around the room instead of just you there sucking up air and smoke.
Right. Yeah. Be dependable. You know, let your yes mean yes and your no mean no. You know,
yeah.
Your word is your bond. You shouldn't have to say I promise or any of that. Just word. And so it is yeah. so. You know, not let your words not return to you void. I agree. Yeah. I get it. Totally. You know, and I feel like a lot of just growing up in Chicago and just experiencing Chicago, you'll have a lot of you're going to have a lot of material, you know, to last you for probably the rest of your career. Would you say, with that being the case, that like Chicago is like this whole mood where it has caused so much elevation, I would say, in the music and the entertainment industry. A lot of, you know, a lot of good stories and a lot of good talent comes from Chicago. And, you know, the fortunate part is, you know, you have a lot of, you guys have a lot of material to bring with you. So with Chicago being a mood like that, you know, what would you say about Chicago's contribution to your career?
I think Chicago gave me a career.
Okay.
Chicago is the thing that lifts me up.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, Chicago is the people that supported me, the whole culture of Chicago. And it kind of go back to what I was saying before, because I gave to Chicago. I gave to Chicago culture. I was just a person that was always a spearhead at when it comes to every movement, like the early 2000s, like when it comes to the footwork and juke music, dance, culture
mm-hmm.
music,
mm-hmm.
come down to which is not just about music now, because now it's about a lifestyle and a feeling and a soundtrack of how it just feel when you in Chicago. You know
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah.
And, so from the juke to the bopping sound type stuff to the footwork, and which is another.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel you. He came right back in here right on time.
Yeah. So I gave a lot to Chicago,
uh-huh.
And I helped a lot of people in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And in turn, Chicago just always rocked with me hard, like
beautiful.
The West Side and South Side, and the up north Wicker Park type of crowd and culture, like the Chance the Rappers and the Vic Mensa. That so from the hood stuff to the alternative type side, like the love that I get, that's what fuels my love that I give, and it's like a circle. Like I just breathe Chicago, you know. I just love it.
That's dope. You can tell, you know, you can hear it in the music. You can definitely hear it in the music. Tell the people where they can actually find your new project, Purple Heart.
You can project Purple Heart everywhere. All the videos you can find on YouTube, but mainly you can really just find it on my website, you know, www.firemanhof.com. You know what I'm saying? And
You can go on all platforms and listen to the music, and you can watch them all on all the platforms as well. But, you know, hell.
All right. Well, you got new music coming out everywhere on everybody. So 1121, y'all lock that in. Fireman is a part of that too. so we have someone chimed in from Facebook, Rodney F. Cruz. He said, "Good evening, ladies." So that's to me and you.
Hello, how you doing?
we have A.B. Robinson. He said, "I see him moving through the industry. I feel more than artist from him. Seems like he was meant to create and help others." And then he said, "Okay, bars." He's talking to you, Fireman. He's like, he sees you, you know, moving through the industry as more than just an artist, but, you know, actually someone that was put in this industry and put here to help others, you know, navigate their way through the industry.
Yeah, I love it.
Yep.
Love it.
So, okay. So the three of you guys, seems like there should be some kind of collaboration happening. What are we thinking? You know, can we get some juices flowing? What are we going to do? What the three of y'all going to do? I would love to see, you know.
Definitely.
Hey, OG Compass. Tell the audience the message you got and win.
We got something. We're gonna make something.
I said tell them the message that you got. Remember why we've been doing this show.
Oh. All right, so yeah, we got something cooking. We have something coming up. Me and Fire gonna put something together for sure.
Yeah.
We've been working, like, honestly, me and Fireman's collaboration has been long overdue. You know, we've worked on a lot of stuff together for other people, but we haven't, like, made anything for us. So I guess that's the next thing we're going to do.
Yeah.
Y'all definitely look like brothers from another mother. Y'all are kindred spirits. That's going to be hot. You know? And then we're going to soften the blow, you know, and put Dior in the mix.
What's up? So do y'all like working with, what's y'all take on working with female artists, you would say?
It's my favorite artist to work with.
Oh, that's beautiful to hear.
It's more natural to me.
Right.
It's more fun. Mm. And it's, you know, everybody know that about me as far as melodies.
Yeah.
That's my calling, much like most of the time when I do melodies. So it's like working with female artists is always dope because it's like a better instrument vocally and shit like that.
Right.
And, you know, it all looks better too on the videos and stuff. I just love it, you know. So
well, hey.
I love that better. Male artists is fun too, but it's
right.
Who wants to just be around a bunch of males all the time, you know?
Yeah, I feel you. Feel you. Yes.
What'd you say, OG? You said hallelujah. What'd you say, amen?
You say that again.
Well, I like that he said melodies because I definitely like playing with different melodies, and you know, I really like. I don't know. I'm the type of person that when I create a song, I like to, especially like the new stuff I'm working on. Can't wait for y'all to hear it. But I like to kind of create like a little like cushion almost, mm-hmm. and you know, put a bunch of different melodies, and just see where it goes. You know, so I'm excited. I definitely want to work with you.
Yeah. When is everyone going to be in LA area?
Soon as hell.
I know, soon, right? I think I was supposed to be there. I think Bun was saying January. I'm not even sure.
January is a hot, you know, month. It's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, January is going to be lit for sure.
For sure. We got releases, you know what I mean? We got singles dropping, music videos. We got Grammy weekend. Yeah. Man.
I'm always in LA. At least a week out of every month, pretty much, I'm already in LA.
Okay.
Even if I'm not.
Well, definitely shoot by the studio. We got to, you know, celebrate this live and live in color. January is a lit month. We got to turn up. Y'all got to come drink this whiskey for real.
Whiskey? Oh, it's got me feeling real warm.
Is that your third? Well, you know, third? Is that the second one?
That's the second. You definitely didn't bore me no more because you said you still ain't drink the rest of that yet. You right.
She was already asking for some more. Your mama probably be like, "That's my girl." I know.
Warm and fuzzy.
I got one more thing to say before we go to the next thing.
Okay.
Because I was high. So look.
What's that?
I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I be hot. We family.
We family. So we all wish we was right now. Come on, you know. Go ahead, though. I'm listening.
Another thing, the whole point of it all is this. Back to the album conversation.
Okay.
One thing about it all is Fireman HOF, His Only Family, is what I represent. So for one thing about the whole concept of what I do as an artist, it's really just about all family and things like that, too.
Right. Okay.
So my album, I got my mom on the intro.
Oh, wow.
I got my granddad on the video backsliding.
Wow.
Sliding. He on that song.
Yeah.
I got a single with my blood brother, E-Dawg. Mm. And he's also my producer who produced like two records on the album too.
Wow.
It's like the Jacksons and stuff. We just all just be adding it. You know, my mama and my granddad, they not singing. So it's dope, but that dope made me.
It's keep coming back, y'all. It's going to be just a few seconds.
Four.
Okay, the last thing we heard was your mama and your granddaddy. That's the last thing we heard.
My mama and my granddaddy is on the album.
Okay.
As well as my brother, E-Dawg,
okay.
One of my singles. Two of my singles on the album. And we the ones who all direct the video. We got our own production company.
Yes.
HR Films, like... Goddamn, some of the videos got shot by my auntie. Like,
wow.
Yeah.
It's a family project.
Yeah, it's raw. So yeah, I just wanted to add that in just to say that. Shout out to my family. Shout out to HOF. Shout out to His Only Family.
Congratulations. Shout out to HOF, Hits Only Family. Fireman HOF. I've always wondered what I was saying Fireman Hoff, but it's Hits Only Family.
It seemed like we all working on projects for real, because I'm rapping on my project too.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Tell us about it. What's
Well, really, it's like I had told you, like I like to kind of sway between different, you know, the singing and the rapping.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like a mix of everything. Mm-hmm. But originally I was going to call it Phases, because when I first started working on it, you know, I was going through a lot of things, and I was like, you know, I want to call this Phases because every song is like a phase,
yes.
Literally.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I'm like, you know what, I'm kind of out of that, so I'm calling it Aura now. So
Aura.
It's like, yeah.
Ooh.
So it's going to be crazy. Inspired me getting his family on there. That's dope as hell. My mom used to sing too. I wish she could hop on there too.
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
In the future.
She going to do it.
My mom is acting. She ain't singing on that.
That's still dope, yeah. Though. You got the family on there. It's a family project. You can't lose.
Creativity at its finest. Yeah. So how deep are you into your project?
I'm deep.
Okay.
I'm deep. I've been like doing, like I have an 8-hour block coming up. Like mm-hmm. I'm just like, because I'll do like a mixing session where I'll just completely like go over the song, like going up the song y'all played on the video.
The homage, yeah.
Yeah, uh-huh. So I sent it to Malik. He was like, that's, he was fucking with it. I was like, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I'm like, I need your approval.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
you know
yeah.
What I'm saying? But that song, I definitely recorded it over about 4 times.
Okay.
And I just kept going back over it. Because like I was saying, I like to like layer songs.
Yeah.
Like I like to have different layers. And then I just go back and I peel off different layers and I add new layers, peel out different layers, add on new layers until I'm like, okay. This sounds it, but I'm really deep in this. It's almost done.
Okay, so it's almost done.
Almost.
So you can't do the projection of the date when we can look for it yet. I know how that is.
I definitely feel like it's probably gonna be like maybe the middle of January, the latest, the middle of January. I wanted to drop it like January 1st, but you know I have a few other things going on right now, so I don't really know how that's gonna work. But
okay.
We'll see.
Okay. Can you tell us about some of the other things going on, or is it like
it's
hush hush until it? I understand. We all know Burundi, right? Everybody on here know Burundi, and he's the king of hush it up. Don't say nothing. Don't do nothing. No BTS. No, you know, behind the scenes. No, nothing until it's time.
Yeah, I got a few people interested in me right now,
uh-huh.
And it's like crazy because I'm not even really like up yet. But
yeah.
You know, like I'm like an underdog. So
they can
like,
see it though.
Yeah, they you know, they're looking at me like, oh, okay, she, you know. But
aw, she's our darling, you guys. But
yeah.
It's coming.
Yeah, it's a few different people trying to manage me right now.
Okay.
And like I was saying earlier, I turned down a lot, just like I said, because I don't want people trying to change me.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of my main things, because
mm-hmm.
I am who I am,
mm-hmm.
you know. And I know there's going to be somebody that's going to come along that's going to let me be who I am. Of course, it's going to change you a little bit in whatever way they need to. But I'm not trying to change completely because I love myself the way I am. So.
Yeah. Well, I think you're very smart. I was listening to a few things that you were saying.
Yeah.
And, you know, and someone just kind of, you know, getting in the industry.
Yeah.
You're making a lot of smart strategic decisions. Like, for instance, the first time you met up with Malik Yusuf, and obviously, who, you know, obviously he's a great, you know, great person, great producer.
Yes.
He's family. He's loved. Yes. No one to fear in this industry.
No one to
However, you made sure that, look, I'm bringing my parents. I want you to sit down with my parents.
Yes.
That was, you know, that was awesome. That showed integrity and strength in you. Just
Thank
that
you so
one
much.
move that you made. And then every time someone is coming to you, you're not so hungry or thirsty to where you're just accepting anything. Now, hopefully you land with somebody at this, you know, soon,
soon.
But the fact that,
choice.
Yeah, the fact that you're taking your time and, you're not just eager to just jump into anything just to be famous or just to.
Of course not. Because that's not what it's about for me. It's more so, it's definitely my dream. It's been my dream since I was a little girl. You know, I just, like I was saying about the confidence, you just got to find that. I just found that day where I was like, enough is enough. Like, what's stopping me but myself, you know? So I just kind of just went for it. And I know that people are not going to really care about the journey. They care more about the results. They only really care when you up. So, and I told myself that. I'm like, the right people going to be there for me now. And if they're not, that's just what it is. But I can't expect everybody to just be there for me and see where I see myself. So, you know, that's what really drives me, because the people that I do have, you know, around and, you know, I'm thankful. But yeah, man, I don't know. I've definitely turned down a lot, you know. I'm not going to say exactly who, but I've turned down just because, like, it's not about the money for me. And I know that, you know, money rules a lot of people's lives. It's about a dream. So it's so easy to take something.
Yeah.
Any opportunity.
Yeah.
Just because it looked good.
Yeah.
You know, but I'm not trying to just take anything and then be in a bad situation, be shelved or you know, or someone trying to change me and, like I said, overly sexualize me, because I'm more so like a Janae type.
You are. Sensual.
Sensual.
You still got the sexy, but it's not, like you said, over sexualized.
Overly.
No.
Yeah. And I know that sells. I know that sells.
But what you do, what you are, sells as well.
It sells
well,
too. Exactly.
Know?
There's a market for me too. Yeah. So, but I know that a lot of it's just easier to take that route. But I just always thought that I deserve better and knew my worth. So.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
You know, you're definitely dropping a lot of jewels.
Thank you.
It's some people out here listening to you, young people as well as older people that's in this industry and still bumping their heads. You know, they can learn a lot from what you're saying. So I'm definitely, you know, impressed and inspired that you're
Thank you so much. You're
standing in your truth. You know, that's beautiful. That's beautiful to see in an art, especially, you know, a lady. We get, you know, we got to, how it is for us in this industry.
Yes.
But you're not afraid to stand your ground.
Mm-mm.
And you got time.
And I got time. Yeah. I mean, one of the offers I did have, he's managing one of the biggest, like, female artists right now.
Okay.
And I just saw, like, how he, you know, how he turned her into something else.
And
I'm like, okay, so what you gonna do with me?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, and I always kept an eye out for that because, you know, I know who I am.
Yep.
And there's a lot of people that don't know who they are. So it's a lot easier to let somebody change you. But I refuse it. I've been through too much and I've worked too hard, came too far, you know, at this age. So I know what I want. So.
You know, I know a lot of people tell you got an old spirit.
They do. Thank you. I've been here before, definitely.
Of course you have. You know what I mean? This time you came determined. Like, this time it's going to be strategic. I know what to do when I get here.
Oh, yeah. I came with a vision this time. I said, ain't nothing stopping me now. You know?
What were you doing when you were a little girl? What was your mom always saying? Like, girl, you know you've been here before.
Oh, yeah. My mom is, like, very spiritual. You know, I didn't really grow up with religion. I more so grew up with having a relationship with God.
That's right.
And being spiritual. I grew up all the auras and chakras and all that shit.
That's right.
So, you know, just getting aligned, you know. So she always believed in me. Mom was really my biggest supporter, you know, and that's why I had brought her with me when I had met him, because I really wanted him to, you know, see that side of me, because, you know, like I said, I didn't know what he was going to think I was, you know, and that goes for any meeting I go into, you know. I try to make sure people know, like, this is who I am.
Yes.
It's not getting wavered no matter what. You know, so.
And you are enough.
Exactly.
You are enough. So so your project is coming up. You have some things coming up that you got to keep on the hush.
Yes.
But into the meantime, where can the people find you at?
In the meantime, you can find me on Instagram at Dior Music. You can find me on YouTube at Dior. And I'm also on Apple Music, Spotify, all the streaming platforms. You can go listen to me. But my project, definitely, I haven't really been trying to drop a lot of singles only because, you know, I want to drop a project that's going to collectively show my sound, you know. Mm-hmm. And it's just so much easier to pitch a project to people, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. than pitch a song. So I'm trying to make sure I get something that's really, like, you know, it shows my worth, you know. Yeah. And when I go into those meetings, I can really get what I deserve off that. So,
well, it's not too shabby. You got your single on Malik Youssef's mixtape.
Yes.
And they can go watch Unavailable again. I know they was intrigued by that video. I sure was. So they can go find that on YouTube, correct?
Yes.
So they can still enjoy you until you drop again.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Most definitely.
All right. So Fireman, what is it that you would like to leave the people with? Just a few words, as well as where they can find you and what you got coming up next. I knew I threw like three questions at you. Let's start with what's next for you.
I want to say free Dodi, R.I.P. Ali. What's next for me is going into 2021. And, you know, I got new projects coming out. One of them is called Chicago Bull. Hey. We're doing some community stuff like that, some philanthropy. We're going to be doing some coat drives, some, you know, some back to school stuff when school opens back up. You know, we're big on that type of stuff. So we're going to be, you know, putting these initiatives together and really just smoking a lot of weed and stay corona free as best as possible.
Yes, sir. You know,
everybody out there, I'm thankful that y'all are alive. Shit. I'm thankful we are alive. And pray for everybody who's going through it right now, because it's crazy in the world. So
it really is.
That's all I got coming up. Just family.
All right, for sure. Before we get to OG, we do have a caller that called in.
Caller,
who is that? Ray Weather. Ray, that's Weather. A tongue twister. Ray Weather. Ray.
Yes.
Are you there, brother? Doing? How are you?
I'm good, and yourself, sister?
Good. Welcome to 2020 Vision.
Nah, I appreciate it. I just want to say hello and congratulations to everybody on the show this evening.
Thank you.
I did call in for Dior, though. I'm a huge fan.
Hey. Oh, thank you so much. How you doing?
Listening in. Nah, you got it. So I just wanted to say a few things. First of all, you are definitely a vibe like a Jhené Aiko or a Summer Walker. You definitely going to be on that level.
Thank you so much.
Like, that's, and then I had a question. So when it comes to collabing with artists, male or females, do you have any that you've ever wanted to collab with out of anybody else before?
You mean who I would collaborate, like, with the first, male and female?
Or just in general, somebody that you always dreamed about collabing with, I guess, is what
I would definitely have to say, female-wise, Jhené Aiko, just because I grew up, like, you know, listening to her albums and just being very inspired by, you know, how authentic she was and not holding her feelings back. And I'm definitely very serious about that because I'm a very real person, you know, and I like to, you know, be relatable and let people know that it's okay to feel things and feel them deeply. And that's what I do when I make music. But I would definitely say Jhené, female-wise. I would say male-wise, as far as, like, rapping, I got way too many of them, I can't lie. shoot. shoot, I mean.
Well, okay, I'll let you think about that one, so.
All right.
So as far as the project Aura, which I think is a dope name.
Thank you so much.
That you picked out for the project.
Thank you.
You got it. So is this going to be more like an EP or like an album? So a short project or a bigger project so people can have a little bit more bulk in your music?
Well, that's why I was saying that I'm really taking my time on it, just because I want it to be something that you can really feel multiple, you know, energies for me, and that's why it is called Aura. So I'm probably gonna do. I was gonna do an album, 12 songs, but I'm actually gonna wait till I sign to do that. So I'm probably gonna hit y'all with about 8 songs, just so that, you know, it's still a good amount, you know. Yeah.
Yep, nice little 8. 8-piece. We'll take it.
There you go. There you go. 8-piece.
And then I got one more. You know, I don't want to hog you. I'm
probably
I got one more for you.
Ask him up.
One of my, obviously, Minute is my joint. You know what I'm saying?
I was Minute?
Some stuff too, but I actually like that cut. So I see you dropped a little snippet of the video. Are we going to get that video before you drop the project, or is it going to be about the same time?
The crazy thing is I actually filmed Minute twice. The video that I filmed, I liked it. I wanted it all to be like that purple scene that I have as the snippet on my Instagram. I wanted it to be all purple like that. But unfortunately, it didn't come out that way. So I was like, oh, okay. And then when it got on the mixtape that it is on, I was like, oh, maybe it doesn't need a video. But I am definitely thinking about a video to that, but I'm going to be dropping two other videos anyways. So I'll probably drop still a video to that. I mean, now you got me thinking about it. Okay, I probably should do that.
All right. That's what we got. We creative, so that's what we got to do. We all got to be having something up next. But I definitely appreciate y'all taking my call.
Thank you so much for talking to me. You have a blessed night.
Y'all do the same.
All right. Thank you for calling in.
My pleasure.
No worries. So who we got? Trinity.
Oh, hi, Mom.
Hi, Trinity. Welcome to 2020 Vision.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, Mom. How you doing?
I just wanted to say I love all of you guys. I think you guys are all great.
Aww.
And I wish the best for all of you.
Thank you, Mom.
Oh, thank you. That's so sweet.
Thank you, Mama Dior.
Aww.
I'll
never, play soft, because I'm sorry.
Oh, my Lord. She loved this song. They're going to have to wait for the project to hear this one.
Oh, okay.
It's a song that she loves. She's like, you can't keep that as an interlude. It needs to be a whole song. And one of my old producers, like, holding on to, like, a lot of, like, songs that I was working on, which is why I have a new producer now who I love. Shout out to Yoni, Joni, Johnny. Yoni, whatever we be calling him, Joni.
Yoni. Say it again. You talking about Yoni. We're not talking about Yonis.
Johnny, Joni.
We're not talking about Yoni.
Yoni Badoni Maloney. Now, shout out to my producer, though, Joni and Green Tea Studios. I really appreciate y'all. I love y'all. But, yeah, I'm definitely going to probably keep that song as an interlude, Mom. They're going to have to wait for the project.
And by
anyway,
the
way, I just wanted to say congratulations to all three of you. I think you guys are fabulous. Keep moving on. Keep being strong.
Aww.
And don't let anyone stop you.
Thank you.
I'll let someone else come and talk. Have a good night, guys.
All right. I love you.
Thank you, Trinity. Thank you. Hopefully, we're going to hear some of your vocals on some of her upcoming music.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
And then when she comes back, when she drops her album, you can come. You know, come to the studio with her. Look at me. It's a family
sure.
affair.
I'm down.
All right.
You all be blessed. Thank you so much.
You as well. Thank you, Trinity.
Bye-bye, Mom.
Aw, so sweet.
She's like a real-life angel. And yeah. I got angel tatted on my neck, but she really an angel, though.
You can feel it. You can hear it through her voice.
Yeah.
Somebody said, hey, Mama, was it Mama Dior?
Yeah, hey.
Sweetheart, we have another caller. Okay, while we're getting this other caller together, OG, what you got coming up next, my brother?
Hey guys, so for me, I just put out my EP now. I just dropped it like in November.
Okay.
So basically, all like I guess the first third of the year, I'm just gonna be working that, pushing that.
What's the name of it?
It's called Rain.
Rain.
It's called Rain. Yeah. It's just called Rain. Rain.
That's
EP.
Hard as fuck.
OG Compass.
Yeah.
Yeah. OG Compass. It's out on all platforms. It's doing pretty well.
Yes.
Yeah. So the push basically starts in January. So it's kind of good that I put it out when I did. But yeah. So I'm just going to be working that tape, just grinding it out, you know?
Why did you name it Rain?
Why?
Yeah. What was the inspiration?
Like, so it was just like a double entendre. Like, yeah.
you know, rain as in like the element rain, like water.
Yes.
Like, you know, because rain like washes you or makes you clean or makes you whole again.
Yes.
And then rain as in to be on top. So just wow. both.
That's
and
dope.
I just figured, yeah. So, yeah. So, yeah, like you listen to the project or the tape or whatever, it's just like tells you my journey basically. Like, basically, a lot, like it's just a bunch of, it's real Toronto, like it's just Toronto tales of just a Toronto guy, or whatever, and how I found like the light within kind of thing, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's called Rain. Yeah, Rain EP. It's out now. You guys check that out. And then, I'll be dropping singles probably. I'll probably drop a couple singles here and there. But yeah, majority of the time I'm just going to be working my EP.
Okay. And obviously they can find that on all platforms. Where can they find you at if they just want to check you out, see what you're doing, go to some of your pages?
Yeah, you can go on IG. You guys can follow me on IG. My Instagram is GCMPVSS. All my tags on everything else like Twitter, Facebook is OG Compass. Yeah, you guys can find me there anywhere. Just search OG Compass. You can Google it or whatever. Everything will pop up.
All right. And if you had to leave something with the people, some of the listening, you guys have been dropping a lot of jewels. Definitely things that people are going to take away from this show, things that people are going to use in their careers. And you just being authentically you, you've just been blessed. It's like blessings just rained on you, you know. Yeah. So if you had to leave some words with the people, what would you say? What would you tell the people?
I'll tell them just work hard, man. Mm-hmm. Just grind, just hustle. Don't let nobody tell you anything. Whatever you want to do, just work towards it and you'll get there.
All right.
That's right.
Word.
For real. That's some real. That's some real, real.
Do we have another caller? Okay. No? Well, okay. Well, you guys, it has definitely been a pleasure to have you all here with me. I was so excited about this hip hop takeover. Next time we come, we got to do a cipher. Yeah. Hopefully we get Malik in the studio. He DJ for us. He had to go to Africa. I wanted it to be, you know what I mean? Right. This whole cipher thing. And hopefully you guys are in the mood to perform for me next time. Y'all got away with it one time. Y'all haven't been really watching the show, because if y'all watched the show, y'all would know that any artist come on here, you ain't getting away without performing something. Damn it. For real, for real. So hopefully you guys come back and we can do a cipher, get Malik in here, you know, DJ, and, you know, it's going to be dope or whatever. And definitely come back when you guys are dropping more projects, and definitely when you guys all hit LA, we got to come up here and celebrate.
Oh,
celebrate
definitely.
The team, the squad, you know. I hope you guys really connect on a project. We would love to hear a project, you know, from the three of you guys. That would be dope.
That'd be so hard, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
That'd be dope.
So was there one caller calling in, or there was, okay, they're just listening?
They just keep dropping in and out.
Okay. All right, you guys. Well, my name is Amira the Songstress, and as always, the moral of the story is love, life, and light. You know, love, that's the only way that we're going to go higher and experience life. And once that happens, we exude the light. Fireman told us about the perseverance through the industry, being an aid and assistance to others, taking his background and creating not just a story, but a career for himself and others. OG told us about just being in the right place at the right time, just doing what you love, just answering the call when it calls you. You know, don't turn your back on it. Keep going forward. And then the right people and the right things and the universe will line up and co-conspire, you know, to make all your dreams come true, to help you manifest. And Dior, she talked about staying steadfast, staying true to her womanness. And,
there we go.
Letting her spirit speak through her to help navigate her through the industry. Mm-hmm. And I'm here to tell you that these formulas, if you will, they're not by mistake, but yet by design. Take these things from these new pioneers of hip hop music, which is pop music, which is popular music, which is the universal language message. My name is Amira the Songstress, and you can find me on Instagram at Amira the Songstress. You can find me on YouTube at Amira the Songstress, Spotify, iTunes, or wherever you like to listen. And remember, stay focused.
No regrets, no regrets, no regrets.
Let me fix my crown, baby. Like dominoes, yeah, it's going down. My feet off the ground, elevated. You feel my soul when you hear my sound. And I don't know why you, like a red light that don't ever change. And you should know why I'm merging to the other lane. No regrets, making hits is a reflex. I'm getting close, don't take a second to second guess. Riding high so you know I'm blessed. Oh, yeah. I'm getting close, I'm up next. No regrets, making hits is a reflex. I'm getting close, don't take a second to second guess. Oh, I'm so tapped in, baby. Yeah, I'm turned on and tuned into that frequency. Bring love and light and healing in my energy. Hear a major difference in these minor melodies. And I don't know why you're familiar faces in strange places. They don't ever. You should know why I'm merging to the other lane. I'm getting close, I'm up next. No regrets, making hits is a reflex. Oh, yeah. I'm getting close, don't take a second to second guess. Riding high so you know I'm blessed. Oh, yeah. I'm getting close, I'm up next. No regrets, making hits is a reflex. I came with the keys to the industry. I came with the keys to the industry. Oh, yeah. I'm built for this. Came with the keys to the industry. I came with the keys to the industry. I came with the keys to the industry. Oh, yeah. I'm getting close. I'm up next. No regrets. Making hits is a reflex. Oh, yeah. I'm getting close. Don't take a second to second guess.